there are three completely different kinds of business models, especially Aereo, which is arguably a problem for the broadcasters.
Certainly the most disrupted to broadcasters, right.
YouTube, which is new to a certain extent with the YouTube channels and all of that. And then Yahoo getting in the game. And, of course, now Twitter with a possible IPO, which could really an impending IPO, which could really increase its ability to create content and distribute content.
Right.
You think those are the biggest players right now?
Well, Google clearly is the biggest player. I mean, Aereo remains to be seen. I mean, it's scaring everybody. Whether it's a practical solution, whether it will ultimately hold up in the courts, yet to be determined. Twitter, I think, is so powerful. And when you talk to brands and chief marketing officers and politicians and people in countries who want to determine their future, it's about Twitter, you know, and Facebook to an extent. So the power, if the combination of social networking, interactivity, engagement between the viewer, the consumer, the user across platforms is so powerful. And it's just beginning. It's just beginning. You know, the key to all of this is, again, how is it monetized and who pays for it? I mean, the biggest problem with digital media is that it's so undervalued. It's so underpriced by advertisers. They don't really, the CPM.
Well, that's the whole Jeff Zucker dollars against pennies.
Well, he was right back when he said it, but it's gotten worse. It's actually gotten worse. It's not better.
In terms of the monetization?
CPMs are going down on YouTube, and that's a distressing, you know. And so people like Aaron McPherson at Yahoo and smart people who are programming, and AOL's doing a fantastic job. Yahoo's doing a fantastic job. And what they're doing now is investing in quality. Hulu gets huge CPMs. Primarily because it's off-network shows,
content,
you know, streamed on.
Yeah.
But now that Netflix has proven that quality can be distributed online, I think it's beginning, that game will start changing. Okay. But the CPMs have to rise because right now it's terribly undervalued.
It's interesting because I used to say if the TV networks don't watch out, what's going on now is Napster. And then you look at the way that the music industry is monetizing its content. The people who are creating that content are severely underpaid because of the way that the finances are worked in the monetization of the music. I'm concerned about that as a television problem.
Well, I don't know that this is an analog or not, but you know, what we all forget is that there were thousands and thousands and thousands of rock and roll bands who were underpaid, who never made anything, right? And there were some that were people who became the Rolling Stones and you know, Coldplay, et cetera. And they became jillionaires. But I went to VidCon this year, a really interesting event in Anaheim that has grown. And it's filled with young 20-something, early 20-something video producers, writer producers, creators. And the vast majority of the 5,000 or 6,000 or so, no, I think there were 11,000 people there this year. 11,000 people. 90% of them make nothing.
Yeah.
But they're doing it for their passion, for their heart, just like those rock and roll bands were. And there's some. There were people there that you and I would never recognize that were the Beatles. I swear to God, they had mobs of people chasing them because they were known for some little video, some character that they started, and they built businesses. And advertisers really are following them and engaging with their fan base. So I think that there's some analogs. I think that the television networks aren't going away. I don't think cable channels are going away. And I disagree that they're like Napster. I don't think they're like Napster. I think they're more alert to the lessons of the music business, which is a disaster.
Somebody had to learn a lesson.
Great
there.
Case study,
yeah.
And I'm sure Harvard has case studies on what happened in the music business. Arrogance, litigation, they tried to litigate their way through, nothing worked.